It's beer o'clock on Real Old Craft Beer. Today we've got a beer from BrewDog and it's a can of the Albino Squid Assassin Red Rye IPA at 7.4% ABV. What a mouthful. We finally got it out. Here's the can. Let's get it cracked into a glass and see what we get. So a lovely looking can then, I gotta be honest. Nice design work. I feel like I missed a trick here with not talking about it, but we'll talk about it in a moment. For me, canned craft beer has been a very much big part of the craft brewing industry around the world now for the last few years. And although BrewDog puts some of their beers in cans, of course, Punk IPA, what else have they put in? I think I've seen 5am Saint in a can maybe, or a few of their, maybe one or two of their beers in cans. This seems like a step change for me. Albino Squid Assassin seems like something very different from BrewDog. Have a look at that. It's a big move away from what they normally produce for their artwork. And I'm pretty excited by this. I'm wondering, yes, they're having to compete on artwork. And yes, are we going to see some really interesting beers coming out now in cans from BrewDog? I hope so. But beer in the glass, one finger, tan coloured head, nice levels of carbonation rolling up the glass, as you can see. It's a dark amber mahogany coloured ale. This beer's coming in, I'm not sure if I've mentioned it, let me show you the beer while I look. 7.4% ABV. Let's get the aroma on this quite clear beer then from BrewDog. Ooh, very interesting. Big punchy aroma. Of course, hops. I love rye. I love a red ale. This seems a classic. It's bready, it's spicy. And of course, as I mentioned, it's nice and hoppy and piney. Let's dive in. Cheers. Waiting. Oh. It's quite a balanced beer off the first taste. I'm waiting. Of course, it's a red rye ale by BrewDog at 7.4% ABV. I'm waiting to be smacked around the chops with hops. But I was kind of just about to... And it never quite happened. I'm still waiting. Nicely carbonated, it's sweet, bready, nice malty taste going on. And then there's this, here we go, second taste. It's hoppier, it's like kind of licorice-y, like a licorice. Got it, licorice flavour in there. And a spice and a bit of plum. It is piney. It is grapefruity. And it's bitter. But... And I mean this in the greatest of respects for BrewDog. It's not BrewDog bitter. It's not smashing you in the chin with the hops, that big, aggressive, grapefruity bitterness. It's just not coming. It's not clawing at me. I mean, Let me make one thing clear. I'm not about to pour the beer down the sink and say this beer is the worst beer I've ever drunk in my life. This beer is a very nice beer. It's a very nice beer. It's very malty and flavoursome and spicy, and there's some licorice in there. There's some pine, there's some grapefruit, but it's all very balanced. It's all very balanced for a 7.4% ABV beer. I suppose being BrewDog, people expect big things from everything that BrewDog brews. I suppose even BrewDog, they must be thinking to themselves, how do we, what do we do with our next beer? Do we just produce the next hoppy beer? The answer, I think, for the public is yes. I think people, there's no, let's get down to business. I'm going into the minutes here. At 7.4% ABV, this is by no means a session beer. So really speaking, this shouldn't, for on BrewDog's part, this really shouldn't be a balanced beer. This should be really aggressive, really kind of smashing your face off with hops. But it's not doing it. It really isn't doing it. It's drinkable. It's sweet. It's spicy. It's malty. And then you have this bitterness on the back end that just isn't quite enough. I understand that the owner, James Watt, is doing a lot of stuff now in America. A lot of TV work. He's opening a new brewery out there. So he's a very, very busy man. But I think if this is the future of BrewDog, I think he needs to get back to the UK a little bit more often and keep an eye on business back home, his roots, where the brewery came from. Produce more Jackhammer, produce more your classic punk IPA. I was in BrewDog Cardiff today and the punk was amazing. It was really good. It was better than this. I'm going to have to rate it. And for me, it's still a 7 out of 10. It's still a 7 out of 10. But for the effort with the artwork and everything else, I was really expecting more. I was really excited today when I picked this up in BrewDog. I was really excited to get it home, get it reviewed. But it just didn't happen. It just didn't happen today. 7 out of 10. I think the last really, really, really good beer that I had from BrewDog was the Invalids and Convalescence beer. That was a stunner. So they can produce amazing beer. They probably should have put that in a can. But this, 7 out of 10, BrewDog can do much better. Thanks for watching. Put your comments in the comments box. Please subscribe to our daily beer reviews. And cheers.